Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro with another video related to AI. So the game of AI, artificial intelligence, is going really fast. I mean, the field is rapidly growing and it's insane. Every week there's a new tool coming up, and some of the tools are actually really, really good. So if you're a developer, so let's say you're a WordPress developer, you should have this tool which is called Smol AI. I tested this tool and created a complete WordPress plugin using this. So I wanted to share it with you guys how I installed that on my laptop, and using my OpenAI key, I created a complete WordPress plugin and tested it on my website. So if you want to learn, and if you want this Smol AI to be your junior developer, watch this video complete. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Comment in the video below if you experienced this tool and if you want to experience this tool. So without further ado, let's get into the screen. So guys, that's the GitHub repo of an AI tool called Smol AI. And I'm gonna be using this to build a WordPress plugin. And I already built a plugin. So let me show you guys what it gave me. So if I go to my WordPress install, and that's the plugin which it created. Now you can see it created PHP, CSS, JS, templates. I mean, it created all the files with just one single prompt. So all I had to do is just go to ChatGPT and ask ChatGPT to build me a simple contact form. I want to build a simple contact form plugin for WordPress. Please write a prompt for me. And ChatGPT gave me this prompt, and all I had to do is just give this input to my Smol AI developer, and it generated a whole complete WordPress plugin. And if I add the shortcode of this plugin, you will see a contact form like this. Obviously, there is a room for improvement, but I'm just showing you that how I was able to build within like a minute. So I created a complete WordPress plugin in just 1 minute by using this prompt and using this Smol AI tool, which has recently came to my contact. Now guys, I'm going to show you guys how you can install that on your laptop and play around with it and try to create some cool stuff just like I did with the plugin thing. So there are other examples already present in this GitHub repo where someone created a ChatGPT plugin, a Pokemon app, a political campaign CRM program. I mean, there are multiple examples which you can also use. And in my example, you'll be learning how to create a WordPress plugin using this tool. So let's go on with the installation. So I'm going to create a new folder on my desktop for this. So let's create a new folder and name it SMOL Smol. And now I'm going to open this in my VS Code. Okay, I have this open. Go to your terminal. And in terminal, add in the command which is given here. So git clone. So I'm just going to copy this and paste here and hit enter. Okay, it's going to take a little while. Okay, we are ready to go. Our Smol is cloned. Smol GitHub repo is cloned in within our folder. And there's another folder called developer. Okay. Now, next step is to sign up with model.com. And it's pretty easy. So just click on sign up from here. Or you can go to model.com/signup. So let's open up this in a new tab. Go back. Because we'll be using this command after we have signed up with model.com. So I'm already signed up here. So I'm just going to log in using my GitHub repo. Sign in with GitHub. You will do the same. You will just need to go to sign up and sign up using your GitHub repository. Okay. Once done, let's move on to the next step, which is this command. Okay, so I'm just going to copy this command and paste it again in my terminal. make sure you are within the developer folder before typing this command. So cd developer, and now just paste this command and hit enter. Okay, once you paste this command to your terminal, you will be redirected to the screen like this, where you will create a new token. Click on create token button. And that's it. Token has been created, right? And make sure when you type in this command, you are within the developer folder, which is created within the small folder, which I created in my desktop. Okay. Now let's go back to the instruction here. Again, another command, just copy this command and paste in here. So it's showing me a requirements already satisfied because I have already installed these requirements. It's gonna be a little different on your screen, but that's the step-by-step process of how you need to install this, right? Now, we need to add in our API key. Now that's where you can go to create your OpenAI API key, which is platform.openai.com/account/API keys. I already have some API keys and I'm going to create a new API key and let's name it SMOL small. And I have my API key ready. Now I'm going to copy this API key to the ENV file. So let's go to example.env file, which you have under developer folder. I'm going to go to this file, paste in my API key after the equals to sign. And now I'm going to rename my env file to .env and remove the .example. Okay. And hit save. So click on file and then save. Now our installation part is completed. Now we'll give this prompt to generate us the code which we need, okay? And in order to do so, let's go back to the GitHub repo. So that's how we will be giving this tool prompt. That's a prompt for a Chrome extension. We can give any simple prompt. And in this tutorial, I'm going to give a detailed prompt which I generated from ChatGPT, right? So I just messaged ChatGPT that I want to build a simple contact form plugin. Please write a prompt for me, where ChatGPT generated a detailed prompt, right? Now I'm going to copy this prompt and paste it to prompt.md file, which we have within our developer folder. I just go to this file. And as you can see, we already have a prompt from this developer, right? So I'm just going to copy my prompt, which I just created from ChatGPT. And that's my prompt. Now, all I have to do is just add in the command in terminal, which is model run main.py prompt.md. So just copy this command from here in GitHub and just paste it here. Okay. I have pasted the command. Now I'm just going to hit enter. It's going to take a little while to create all of the codes which we need in order to have a plugin. So once you run the command, you will have a new folder called generated. And within that folder, you will have all the generated files. Okay, our app is completed now. Now, if I go to my desktop and go to the folder which I created. So that's the folder which I created. And here's Smol AI. So within my developer folder, we have generated folder. And in generated folder, there's another folder called wp-content. So all of the plugins in WordPress are within wp-content folder. And in here we have plugins folder, and there we have our plugin files. And if I navigate within this folder, it has all the required files, CSS folder, JS folder, PHP file, and again a template file. And I can simply upload it from here to work to my WordPress install and make it work. So let's try that and make it a zip in order to upload it to my WordPress. So here's the zip folder. Now I'm going to delete the plugin which I already had installed before. So it's basically the same thing which it generated because I used the same prompt, right? So let's try deleting that one and installing the plugin. Click on add new and let's upload the plugin file. So I'm going to go to small folder in my desktop, developer, then in generated folder, we have another folder and here's the zip file which I created. Now simply upload that and click on install now. And as you can see, it's asking me to activate the plugin, meaning the plugin is working completely fine. And if I go to tools, plugin file editor, you can see that it's showing up the code properly. So all of this code is written by an AI tool. I didn't write a one single line code in order to make my plugin work. Obviously, there's a room for improvement. When we see this, so let me refresh this. Yep, it's working fine. So there's a CSS folder, JS folder, templates folder, and this .php file where we can see that it has registered a short code for the WordPress plugin. Cool, right? So it's a really cool tool to create a boilerplate for your plugin, for your next plugin project. You should definitely use it. And there's more to it. I mean, you can also debug if you're seeing any error on your tool. So there's a debugger command, model run debugger.py, and whatever error you get, you can simply add in to your prompt in your VS Code terminal and it will debug all of the issues which it might have when you try to attempt it for the first time. So that's it for the tutorial, guys. I hope you guys will try this new tool and play around with it to create some new and exciting plugins or whatever you want to create using this tool. Until next video, have a great day.